Hi guys, me again, John in Tucson, this guy right here. I haven't really put up a video in a while. Once again, life gets in the way and, you know, I just kind of run out of time. I won't go into things about that. You may hear lots of noise in the background. That would be Milo the kitten. It's about 5 a.m. here, it's still very dark, and he's a nocturnal animal, so he loves to play all night long. So he's probably going to play throughout this video, which is great. Anyway, tonight's reaction video, it's not going to be Regine. Sorry, guys. Once again, this is Leonid and Friends. They're the Russian cover group doing Chicago songs and Earth, Wind, and Fire songs. This is a new one. This is a really good one. It just popped up in my feed probably about an hour ago. It's always been a favorite of mine, and these guys are doing it, knocking it out. It's a wonderful piece. And let's go ahead and take a look and listen to this, shall we? I, of course, will be doing my normal silly things. I will try not to sing along. Because you don't need to be hearing that come out of my craw. So let's give this a shot and see what happens, guys, okay? Just for the heck of it. Hope everyone's having a great day in the meantime. And thank you all, my new subs, my subs that I've had since the beginning. You guys are awesome. Thank you for the support. I really do appreciate it. So without any more wasting of time, let's get on with this, okay? Hey John, see you John. All right, this is called Call On Me. Leonid and Friends, of course, are a Russian group doing a cover of Chicago songs. And of course, I will leave the link to this particular video in my description. So let's go, guys. Yeah. Brilliant. Ah, absolutely brilliant. Let's get rid of this. Let's go back to this fool here. And yeah, wasn't that awesome? Once again, this Russian group, doing covers of Chicago stuff and Earth, Wind, and Fire. They are so spot on with everything they're doing. In my opinion, still, I think they're tighter and sound just that much better than the original group Chicago. And I know that's sacrilege for a lot of people to hear that, but to me, that's what I'm hearing. I mean, there's such precision of the sound and the timing and everything. It's just, it's all right there. Story time. I'm not religious these days at all. In fact, I'm quite anti-religion in lots of ways. However, there was a time in my life, in my younger life, I was 20 years old, 19 years old, 20 years old, something like that. I became a Mormon church, and got baptized, went through the whole thing. They fast-tracked me and said, you need to go on a mission. I'm like, absolutely, I want to go on a mission. Well, they send you to Provo, Utah, where BYU is located. And it's basically a campus of BYU to a degree, and all they teach are languages and how to be a missionary, a Mormon missionary. English-speaking missionaries back then, they were there for 2 weeks, I think, and they were shipped out. Foreign language missions, you were there for 2 months. And it was, 12 hours a day studying, 7 days a week for 2 months to learn the language of the country that you were going to visit. Lots of pressure, lots of tension. A lot of people crying, a lot of people lost it and went home because it was intense, very, very intense. Well, the church did not want us to have any music with us other than church music or maybe classical, something like that. Well, I broke the rules from the onset, of course. I had Carpenter's CDs with me, or tapes with me, because that's back when cassettes, that was my era, cassettes. I had a little Sony Walkman, cassette Walkman. So I had cassettes, I had the Carpenters, I had Earth, Wind, and Fire, and I had Chicago. I think it was Chicago 15 that I had at the time then. But I'll tell you what, Chicago and the Carpenters got me through that pressure cooker of learning a brand new language. I couldn't speak Spanish, and I lived in the desert Southwest my entire life, where Spanish is spoken by the majority of the populace. I couldn't understand it, and I studied it for 4 years in school. Got straight failures. It was that bad. But I learned it. I can speak it pretty fluently at this point, despite it being 30 years ago that I learned the language. But yeah, just a cute little story there. Music, to me, it's a balm, it's a salve for whatever is making you hurt or is just putting the thumbs to you, thumb screws to you and really putting the pressure on. Music always calms me down, takes me to my safe place. I know I'm going to be fine with music. And that's why I'm doing this with you guys. That's why I share it with you. Again, thank you. All of the people that have subscribed to my channel, all of your comments, thumbs up or down, I don't care. You know, that's a stupid little game that YouTube has us all play, and I don't understand why. Music is very, very important. And I just thought I'd put this video up for you very quickly. And next videos that I put probably will be about RVs and lithium batteries and solar and all that stuff again. Like I said, there's so much to go into, and that's going to be my future. So we'll leave that for another day. At any rate, guys, have a terrific day. Treat yourselves great. Treat your fellow man great. Treat them the way you want to be treated. It goes a long way towards easing the tension in all of our daily lives. You know, do something for someone you don't know. Cheer them up. Don't tell anyone you did it. You'll reap the benefits, trust me. You pay it forward, it comes back to you. It always does. So in the meantime, you guys have a terrific day. I will put this up, and we'll see what happens next. You guys have a good one. Take care. Bye-bye.